And treachery is sweetly done. Now you've entered the asylum. This profession unique. Actors are children, playing hide and ego seek. So welcome, Miss Eve Harrington, to this business we call show. Unsheathe your claws, enjoy the game. You'll be a bitch, but they'll know your name. From New York to Kokomo, welcome to the theater, my dear. You'll love it so. Concrete hallways, welcome to the friendly roaches too. Welcome to the pinches from the stagehands, it's the only quiet thing they do. Welcome to the Philadelphia critics, welcome Librium and Nebutol. Welcome to a life of laryngitis, welcome to dark toilets in the hall. Welcome to the flock you thought would run for years. Welcome to the world of fears and cheers and tears. Welcome to the theater. With some luck, you'll be a pro. You'll work and slave and scratch and bite. You'll learn to kill with sheer delight. You'll only come alive at night when you're in a show.
Lucas, and I'm your host and cop here this afternoon. Welcome, 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 welcome. Nice to see you all out and about. And at our age, that's a bloody benefit, isn't it? Well, it is the sum of us. I've been doing this that long. I must feel like I should retire, but I'm not. No, not when there's lovely people like you that come and support us. For those who don't know the history of DT... For those who don't know the history of DTs, they're fucked. This is where it's all happening. I meant to say Broadside, the history of Broadside, was done so that us old Sheilas and some of you young little chickies that are getting around somewhere can go out and meet lovely people and spend an afternoon one day a month, catch up, see how everyone's going instead of waiting for their fucking funeral and going along. And it saves you a bunch of flowers too. But we do have a fabulous show, I must apologise for you. Unfortunately, we don't have Miss Judy LeBonc again. Aww. She's a fucking sick woman. No, I mean she's not healthy. No, poor Judy's rocked up the other day. I thought she'd been in a fight, her bloody eye was out here, was red as ever. She's got conjunctivitis. Try saying that after a few burnos. Conjunctivitis. So unfortunately, she couldn't be she had an eye patch on. She looked like a bloody second-rate Betty Davis thing. You know, she's just as evil, because they're both areas. But We still have a great show. I mean, it's done my head in all week trying to get it done, but that's why we have three fabulous guests. We have the fabulous Miss Connie Lingus with us tonight. For those of you that don't know Connie, and I mean, she's a legend. Connie got her first production show working with the late Michael Michelle and myself at The Exchange. So it's a great pleasure. And Connie's going to actually fill in for Judy in one of the next numbers, and I told Judy Connie's good. She can fuck off because Connie's going to take her place. We also have back the very camp, the fabulous Miss Anita Mann. I've asked her to reprise this fabulous number that she does. And for a little bit of glamour, we've got Madison Dupre. Now, I would like to thank, before the show even starts, I'd like to thank Madison and Anita because, see, I haven't done any work with Sharon other than trios. And I thought, what am I going to do? Solo numbers. This is going to do my fucking head all the fucking. So I like to have a couple of numbers or doubles or a production number or whatever. So I said to the girls, what can we do? Well, they've actually got me doing a shared number with them in the second show. So this will be quite fun. Never rehearsed it with them. We've done it all over the phone. This is modern technology, yes. Yes. Well, it was modern because it was one of those mobile things. So we do mobile phones. What about bloody technology? Isn't it amazing? And the language they use, they have certain things to describe what it does and what it does and what it doesn't do. And it's dreadful, isn't it? Dreadful, except for you, darling. I mean, you really know how to work the system, don't you, Anthony? Put your hands together, listen. We've got Anthony and Ronnie. We've got the lovely Lindsay. Lindsay and... I obviously embarrassed her assistant last time because she's not wearing that dyke.
Dyke shirt.
That dyke check shirt. We've got. Oh, here she is over there. I just got totally blank, darling. I've forgotten your name. So, Jane, Amy, tell me what it is like. The fabulous is Amy Jane, of course. She's come to see Jude, poor old Jude. She's sitting at home suffering. I bet she fucking is. But anyway, we do have a great show. Also, when I come out next time, make sure you've got your tickets handy because I do have a door prize to give out. But right now, we would like you to put your hands together, when I finish talking, of course, put your hands together when I finish with the fabulous Miss Sharon Starr. She's just come back from a successful tour of Europe. She wrecked havoc in Marrakesh. She left before the place got flooded, the mountains blew up. So without further ado, and the poor dear, she's so excited about coming here today, she left her jewelry and her shoes at home. Oh. I forgot there was jewelry there.
Thank you.